माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिस मुनज्जा सैयद वेलकम यू ऑल टू नागेश करजगी ऑर्किड स्कूल. टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू इंग्लिश सब्जेक्ट ऑफ ग्रेड टू. येस, यू आर राइट. सो चिल्ड्रन, नाउ यू माइट बी थिंकिंग वेन टीचर विल स्टार्ट टीचिंग द रिमेनिंग स्टोरी ऑफ एंड फ्रेंड्स, राइट? बट बिफोर दैट वी शुड नॉट फॉरगेट आर गुड थॉट. ओके, सो टूडेज गुड थॉट इज स्लो एंड स्टेडी विन्स द रेस. स्लो and steady wins the race. Children, now as soon as I say this good thought, you might have remembered the story of hare and tortoise. Yes? So what was the lesson we got from that story? That we should not do any work in hurry and we should not be overconfidence. Okay? So when the things will be overconfidence, our thinking and our mentality will change. No, this is so easy, I can do that. But whereas the tortoise was slow, but he never stopped anywhere and he wins the race. So in that same way, to do anything, we should have patience so that our patience and our efforts will definitely make us successful. Okay? Now, the story we are going to see. First, I'll recap the story till what we have learned. Then we are going to move for the next part. Okay. Now, as you have remembered, on that day, one boy was alone. Who was that boy? Tony. Very good. So, Tony was alone. And what was Tony doing daily? Means what was his routine? He will play with his friends. Okay, but when he will play? After the lunch. So he was playing daily with his friends after the lunch. But on that day it was only 10 o'clock in the morning, so his friends were not with him to play. So what he thought, that he wanted to go out, so he took his mother's permission and he went out to play. Then mother also said, okay beta, you can go to play. When the lunch will be ready, I will call you back. So what Tony did, he went to the garden. So in the garden, what you will see, children? Yes? Colorful flowers, trees, green leaves. So in that same way, Tony also loved to see those colorful flowers and fruits, leaves, that scene he loved. So after that, what he will do in the garden when he will go? He will play with three things. Okay, what are those things, children? Old tin bucket, yes, pail, bundle of sticks and dry leaves. Very good. So Tony loved to play with dry leaves, old tin pail, P-A-I-L. Now what do you mean by pail here? Pail means old bucket. Okay. Third one, bundle of sticks. Sticks, bundle. As I told you, not only one stick, it will be bundle. Means more than one stick will be there. So Tony wanted to play with that and he was playing also. But after some time he found something else. What was that, children? When he was playing in the garden, he found something else. What was that? It was a old broken log. L-O-G, log. Now what do you mean by log? In our last period I told you, children. Yes. Log means a big piece of wood, but that wood will belong to tree. Okay, a big piece of wood. So on that log, what he found, children? Black ants marching up and down. What they were doing? They were marching up and down. So in that way, they were marching. Marching means what? Walking like a soldier. Okay. They were going up, again they were coming down. So this the black shiny ants were doing. So what he thought, now if you will see something like this, many questions will come in our mind that why they are here, what are they doing, from where they have come, where they will go. So these all the questions were also in Tony's mind. So Tony was very much, he was excited to know about those things. So what he did, he went close near to the ants and he saw on the log the black shiny ants were going up. But what he saw that they were carrying the food in their mouth and they were struggling hard and they were going up and they were coming down. So after that, Tony was watching them carefully. Carefully means was ekdam dhyan se, he was watching what exactly they are doing. So he was watching that. Then after, we are going to see the next part now. Okay, so open your Canopy textbook, children. Lesson number 3 of English, Ant Friends, page number 19. Yes, 1919. Have you all removed, children? Yes, in our last period, you can see on this picture, in this picture, I have explained you, this is Tony's garden, and he was, see, you can see the expressions, how Tony is giving, actually, he is watching them carefully. Means, what are they doing, actually? So, in this, I have explained already, the ants were carrying the food in their mouth. So, some were on the log. Some ants were on the log with the food in their mouth. And some were, here you can see the broken piece of this log. From this side, they were going inside. And some ants were keeping the food inside the log. You can see the line is going up. Means now this first one ant will go inside the log from here. And it will also keep the food there and it will come back. Now the next part. Turn the page, children. Have you all turned? Okay. Now I will read. Keep your finger in your textbooks as I'll read. Then, T-H-E-N, then they came out again to get more food. Who came out here, children? The ants, exactly. The ants came out again. From where they have come out, children? Into the log, yes. From the log, they have come out and they were collecting more food. As the last point of our this story is, some ants were inside the log and some were up of the log. So here, after some time, they came out again to get more food. They moved to one side to let others pass. They moved, M-O-V-E-D, moved. Repeat the spelling after me. M-O-V-E-D, moved to one side. So what the ants did? They moved to one side. See, you can see here, this is the line going from one side. Okay, now this side is empty. Why they have kept this side empty, children? When the ants will go from this side, they will keep the food inside the log, and the other line of the ants will come from this side. Means with the understanding, they were giving the place to come another line. Means let others pass. They were going from one side and another line of ants is coming from the other side. See, you can see in this picture. Here, from here one side, the ants, they have food in their mouth. See here. All of them are having, na? Yes. So, they are going to keep inside the log and this side is empty. Means, any single ant is not here. So, from here, these ants will go and keep the food inside the log and that only line will come back again from here. They worked together and carried big pieces of food. They worked together. Now, who worked here together, children? You and me? No, then ants. Very good. So, the ants work together. Together means ek saath, with each other. Together and carried. They were carrying. You can see here, they are carrying the food. Carried big pieces. Means as compared to their size, they were handling the big pieces of food. They went up and down and up and down. Repeat the spelling. U P up, D O W N down. So to keep the food, first they will carry the food in their mouth, they will go up to the log, they will keep the food inside the log, again they will come down. So they were working very hard for collecting the food and they were just going up, down, up, down continuously. But they never stopped to rest. But they never, N-E-V-E-R, never, but they never stopped, S-T-O-P-P-E-D, stopped. So the ants, they never stopped anywhere and they didn't did any of the rest. They were working hard to collect the food. After that, Tony watched the ants for a long time. So what Tony did, he was watching the ants for a long time. Means very carefully he was watching them. How the ants will collect the food, how they will climb the log, how they are holding the food in their mouth, how they will go inside. Then they will keep the food. Again, those ants will come down from the log to collect more food. So, Tony was watching everything for a long time. Then he heard his mother calling him. So what happened next? When Tony was busy to watch the ants, then he heard that. Heard. H-E-A-R-D. Heard. हर्ड माने सुनना, ऐकने, ओके. सो देन ही हर्ड हिज मदर कॉलिंग हिम. एम ओ, रिपीट द स्पेलिंग आफ्टर मी चिल्ड्रन. एम ओ टी एच ई आर, मदर. सी ए डबल एल, कॉल. नाउ वी वॉन्ट टू से कॉलिंग, सो कॉल्स आई एन जी वर्ड विल बी कॉलिंग. गुड. सी ए डबल एल आई एन जी, कॉलिंग हिम. नाउ टू हूम मदर वॉज कॉलिंग चिल्ड्रन? टू टोनी. वेरी गुड. टाइम फॉर लंच, टोनी. सो इन दैट टोन मदर कॉल टोनी. टाइम फॉर लंच, एज इन द मॉर्निंग ओनली मदर सेड टू टोनी दैट यू कैन गो आउट टू प्ले इन द गार्डन एंड आई विल कॉल यू व्हेन द लंच विल बी रेडी. सो नाउ द टाइम फॉर लंच वॉज देयर, मीन्स द लंच वॉज प्रिपेयर्ड बाय हिज मदर एंड मदर कॉल्ड हिम. इट वॉज नून ऑलरेडी. एन डबल ओ एन, नून. नून मीन्स एग्जैक्टली 12 o'clock ड्यूरिंग द डे, मीन्स इन अ डे एग्जैक्टली द टाइम विल बी 12. सो वी आर टेलिंग बिफोर 12 o'clock गुड मॉर्निंग एंड 12 इट विल बी नून टाइम. सो आफ्टर 12, आफ्टर 12 o'clock we are telling good afternoon. Understood children? It was noon already. A L, all ready spelling is here. R E A D Y, ready, already. He was feeling very hungry. Hungry means what? भूख लगना. Okay. He was feeling very hungry. Who was hungry here, children? Tony. Very good. So, he was feeling very hungry. F double E. Repeat the spelling after me, children. F double E L I N G. Feeling. V E R Y, very. H U N G R Y, hungry. He was feeling very hungry, so he jumped up and said goodbye. So what Tony did? Tony was sitting and watching the ants. When he heard his mother is calling, time for lunch, Tony. In this way, his mother called. So he jumped. J-U-M-P, jump. If we want to make it ED, means past tense, which had happened already. So jump plus ED together will spell jumped. J-U-M-P, ED, jumped. Jumped up and said goodbye. G double O D, good. B Y E, bye. Together, goodbye. I will see you tomorrow morning. T O, repeat the spelling. T O M O double R O W, tomorrow morning. M O R N I N G, morning. So Tony jumped and said goodbye to his friends and he said that I will meet you and I will see you tomorrow morning. His aunt friends nodded their heads. So what they did, aunt friends, they nodded the heads. Nod, nod means hilana. Okay, they were shaking their heads. His aunt friends nodded their heads, but did not talk. So what they did, when Tony said goodbye to them, they said okay, means they have nodded their heads, but did not talk. They not talked with Tony. Repeat the spelling now, children. Friends. 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 Nodded. 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 THEIR. Their heads. 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 But did not talk. 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 Because they were still busy. BECAUSE. Because they were still busy. Who are busy, children, here? Very good. The ants were busy marching up and down. Means they were walking like soldiers. They were going up and they were coming down. That day means when Tony met these ants, on that day, Tony learnt an important lesson. Tony has learned the important lesson. Lesson means he has learned something good from them. That is, to always work hard. So, Tony has learned that always work hard. You can see when Tony said goodbye to the ants only nodded their head. They not said anything. They not stopped their work. So, they were always working hard. In the same way, we should also work hard always and work together as a team. So what we have to do? We have to work together. Means in a team. Team means what now? In that team, more than one people will be there. Now in your team, your friends will be there. So we have to always work together as a team to achieve success. Children, do you remember any good thought related to these points? That always work hard and work together as a team. Yes, unity is strength. I said you this good thought before also. Means unity means what? In a team. Together we are working. So is our strength. Means we can do any work. We can face any problem when we are in a team. But being a team, in that many rules you have to follow. Rules in the sense we have to work hard with each other. We have to understand. So in this lesson also, the ants were understanding each other. They were giving the sight to the other ants to march up. And they all were working hard. In the same way, we also have to do, children. Okay. Now here we have a question. Yes. put these sentences in the correct order by numbering them 1, 2, 5. Now here we have A, B, C, D and E point. What we have to do? These sentences are not in a sequence. They are mixed. So what we have to do? We have to arrange them in numbering 1 to 5. Tony was very hungry. So he jumped up and said goodbye to the ants. Children, first of all, we will read all the sentences. Then you will come to know which sentence will be first. The ants went up and down, but never stopped to rest. The ants nodded their heads at him as they went up and down the log. The ants worked together and carried big pieces of food. Tony's mother called him for lunch. Now, what will be the sequence, children, here? Suddenly, Tony not said goodbye. When he said goodbye, when his mother called him. Okay. But before that, something has happened in the story. Do you all remember? Before his mother called him for the lunch, the ants went up and down and they never stopped. This has come afterwards. Now you only have to tell me, children, which will be the first point. When ants nodded their heads as Tony said them goodbye. Right. So after this point, A point, this C will come. The ants worked together and carried big pieces of food. Now when it come, you have to arrange it in a sequence. Okay, I'll show you the answer now. A1 will be fourth. D is first one. The ants worked together and carried big pieces. After that, the ants went up and down, but they never stopped to rest. Then Tony's mother called him for lunch. Tony was very hungry, so he jumped up and said goodbye to the ants. And lastly, the ants nodded their heads at him as they went up and down the log. They were still busy to collect the food. Okay? So children, now we have completed the lesson. A very good lesson, a very good point from the ants, from animals. We can learn many things, children. In the same way, how ants were doing the hard work, they were working as a team. So we have learned many things from the ants, that work in a team, don't rest for a long time, work as a team and work hard. Okay. So in this lesson, we have learned these many things. Now your homework is you have to read the lesson number 3, Ant Friends, and you have to underline the new words and the meanings of some of the words has given in the textbook itself. That you have to learn and you have to write it only one time, like single time in your HW book. Okay, suppose you have underlined the pail word, P-A-I-L. What you have to write? P-A-I-L. But properly touching those double lines, you have to write, children. Sharp your pencil before writing and complete your homework and read the lesson. Okay? Thank you.